ओके, नाउ लेट्स लुक एट एन एग्जांपल वेयर वी विल कन्वर्ट द नॉन कैनोनिकल फॉर्म और नॉर्मल फॉर्म व्हाट एवर इट इज टू कैनोनिकल फॉर्म स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म. ओके, सो सम रैंडम एक्सप्रेशन इज गिवन टू यू. एफ वन इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी बार सी. नाउ इट्स अ सम ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट टर्म, दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट टर्म एंड सम इज देयर बिटवीन. सो सम ऑफ प्रोडक्ट टर्म, बट इट इज नॉट इन कैनोनिकल फॉर्म बिकॉज यू कैन सी ईच टर्म इज नॉट हैविंग ऑल द वेरिएबल्स. So we will convert it, and you have to convert in this fashion all the time. Okay, so what we will do is, since b and c are missing in this term, so what we will do, we will multiply it by b plus b bar and c plus c bar, because both the terms are missing. And with the OR law, if you remember, this will be 1, b plus b bar will be 1, c plus c bar will be 1, so ultimately it will be a only. Okay, similarly here a is missing, so what you will do, a plus a bar. Okay, b bar c. Now this expression and this expression is same, there is no difference. Okay, because these are one. Now what you do, multiply and open the bracket. So what you will get here is a b plus a b bar multiplied with c plus c bar plus a b bar c plus a bar b bar c. Again open it. What you will get is a b c plus a b c bar plus a b bar c plus a b bar c bar plus these two terms remaining, a b bar c plus a bar b bar c. Now you can see this, we have converted to this long expression. Now here you can see each term is having all the three variables, so now it is standard canonical form. Okay, so this is how you can convert in the sum of product case. So we will see for product of sum cases as well, but some product of sum cases as well, but sum of product right now I want to explain. Okay, once you will get this expression, there is something called min term which you can see. Okay, now what we will do, we will make the min terms. So here what we are following, one will be represented as normal form, means you can say normal form is represented as one, I should make line like this, and complemented form will be represented as zero. Okay, this is what we will follow. So depending upon this, what this will be, 111, this will be 110, this will be 101. Because bar means complemented form means 0. Okay, 001. Okay, this will be called as 7. Total you can see, we will see in the number system, but if you are aware already, then this will be 7. So I'll write it M7. Okay, now I will remove this because my work is done here for marking this. Okay, so we'll always follow 1 as normal and 0 as complemented. So this is M7, this is M6. So it is binary, right? So 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2 types. No, sorry, it's octet. We will see that in number system, but just bear with me right now. I wanted to explain. So it's a octal system, it is going on. So total this is 7. Okay, this is 6, this is 5, this is 4, this is 1, this is 5. Okay, I have already have this. Okay, so both will be similar. If you have two terms similar, then you can remove one. Okay, no issues. So you have total 3, 4, 5 terms. Now if you will make table of min terms, remember we have 7 min terms, 6, 5, 4, 1. Okay, so now you can make a truth table from this for F1 that will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay? And this was A, B bar, A bar, B bar, C bar, 0, 0, 0. And this means A bar, B bar, C. This means A bar, B, C bar. And this means A bar, B, C. Okay? Then this one means A, B bar, C bar. This means A, B bar, C. This means A, B, C bar, and this is A, B, C. Okay, so we have term 7, 6, 5, 4, 1. And this is M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. So that is how you can see that how each term is signifying which combination. Okay, so we have M7 and 1, 4, 5, 6. These are the min terms which are called as min terms. Okay, these are called as min terms. All min terms. And in our function, that F1 function, these 4, 3, 4, 5 are present. Okay, total this many can be possible, which are called as min terms. And for our function F1. Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are present. Okay. So, what I want to note here is every product term, that is these guys, product terms, in standard SOP, this is standard, sum of product is called as min terms, which is very important. Okay, and this is the combination for three variables only. Okay, A, B, C, three variables are there. So only 8 combinations are there. If you will have 4 variables, 16 combinations will be there. So that is how you can imagine, and you can write in this way. F1, if you have to write in terms of min terms, then F1 will be equal to sum m, small m, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is how you represent. Okay, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the way you represent. So I have told you about how to represent in SOP and POS. Then I told you how to represent in canonical form. If you have random function, what is canonical form we saw. Then we saw the min terms, how we can extract min terms from each term, each product terms. You can see each product term signifies min terms, and we represented our function, what original function was, in terms of min. Okay, instead of expression, we have now min term representation. So this is comes in handy very when you will have minimization techniques that we will see. Now quickly we'll see an example for max term as well, or product of some case as well. Okay.